3 mistake that married women make. This number 3 is familiarity over familiarity. You know, after you've been married for a couple of years, you've seen the man sneeze, you've seen the man poo, you've seen the man nakedness, you've seen the man do everything, both sickness, everything. You've seen the man fail, you've seen the man succeed, and you feel like now that you've seen everything about the man, no more respect. Remember what they always say, too much of familiarity bring contempt. Don't let your own be like that. I'm telling you, because remember what happened even in the Bible, where I know I'm not a Bible scholar, don't quote me, the book of Esther, if you read it, if you're a Christian, read it, the book of Esther from 1 to 22. What did he say? Remember what Vashti did to the king of Persia when she refused? She was having her own banquet, the king was having his own banquet, and then when he called, he sent somebody to call his wife Vashti, and then she refused because she thinks she was on top of the world, because she thinks that she is now Alpha and Omega. She refused to come and answer. She sent back the messenger to say, tell him I'm busy. And then the members of the cabinet started advising the king to take another wife. That was how Esther became the wife of the king of Persia. So I'm just trying to say to you that if you know that you are disrespecting your husband, and you're like, oh, if you want to go and marry another wife, he will marry another wife, auntie, he will. I know that you too, you can go and marry another man. But I'm telling you, as a married woman, no matter how long you've been married for, try to respect your husband. Try to see reasons. I'm not saying that you should sleep on the floor. No, but you see your husband, he paid your bride price, he got married to you. Respect him. Because if you respect him, he will respect you, and the children will learn to respect the both of you as well. I'm not saying that I'm perfect, but we are learning every day. I hope that this will be able to help everybody to adjust in one way or the other. Remember, even if it's in the Bible, is in the Bible that the king went to marry Esther, but whereby somebody has to give way for another person to give way. If you want to be disobedient, maybe it's another person's prayer to come and take your place in your husband's house. May God not let that one happen to us in Jesus' name. So therefore, my brothers and my sisters, let's strive. Don't let over familiarity with you and your husband bring contempt. Okay, please, I'm begging you, make sure that even though you are familiar with him, he's loose with you, he can tell you everything, you know his secret. So women always hold their husband's secret against them. Do not hold your husband's secret against him. You are not Delilah. He told you that secret because he loves you. So why do you want to use the secret against him? It is wrong. So that is number 3. So number 4, we're going to move straight to number 4. Number 4, taking leadership role. As a woman, many women want to take the leadership role in their home. I'm not saying if your husband is broke, you should not help him financially. I'm not saying you should not also make decisions in the house. But however, as a woman, try to step back a bit and let the man lead. After all, when Jesus Christ was creating during creation, he created Adam and he created Eve. And he said, Eve will be a helper to Adam. It did not say that Eve should come and be the leader of Adam. I know that some women, you might be smarter than your husband, you might be more educated than your husband, you might even be richer than your husband, or maybe you went to overseas before your husband, so you think that now you have to control everything. No, because at the end of the day, if your daughter see how you are living in that your house, she's going to also take that to her marriage. If your son see that the father, because now you are the mother is doing everything, your son will also get married and will become lousy and let the wife do everything. Sometimes you have to step back, even though you know that thing that is going on. I'm just going to give you an example. Some women, if you are richer than your husband, maybe you get paid more than your husband. So when the school fees come, you don't even want to discuss with your husband. You just want to take the money. Oh, I've sorted the school fees. I've sorted this. It's a good thing. I'm not saying it's not a good thing. But always inform your husband of the decision that you want to make. For example, your children has been booked for them to go to an excursion or something. Reasoning with your husband. Oh, honey, the children, they've said that they want to go on excursion. What do you think about it? Do you think I should get them ready, or do you think I should not get them ready? Do not take decision. You are not the leader. He is the leader. Because especially in Europe where we are living, many of us have just left our husband. Like, we want to take care of the car, we want to take care of the rent, we want to take care of this. And that is where many of the men will say, don't worry, my wife will take care of it. If you start taking care of something where you know that you're not going to see it to the end, it's your fault. Because at the end of the day, the man will just say, my wife will take care of it, and the man will just relax. If I was the man, I would relax. Because I know that you will not even ask me before you take care of it. A lot of married women make that mistake. You want to be the leader because you think you are the smartest. Your husband did not go to school. You are the one that had the almighty degree. So now, because of that, you want to be the leader. You want to be the director. You want to be the one that will say whatever you say in this house must come to pass. Even if the man see reason with you that what you are saying does not make sense, you want to be the leader. I'm telling you that is not right. That is not right. So the last but not the least, which is the fifth mistake a lot of married women make, I cannot even overemphasize this, that mistake is lousiness. Many married women, because you are married, you think that you are not going to be looking after yourself. Why would you look after yourself? Even if you are fat, my dear, put on that nice dress, put on your lipstick, put on that makeup, treat yourself, rest when you are supposed to rest, eat when you are supposed to eat, sleep and give yourself rest. Don't go and kill yourself. There was one viral video that was going on about one pastor missus, I can't remember her name, and she said, women, rest. In this coronavirus time, if you call a lot of women on Zoom or you call them on FaceTime, you can tell that some women, even 4 o'clock, they have not had their baths. What is happening? Please take care of yourself, because this man that you are seeing today, you are just using hands to push him left and right. Another person is looking. So therefore, women, please look after yourself. That your hair net, please wash it. Because I've been to some of the people I know, their hair nets. I've been to some of people's house, and if you see their hair nets, if you put it in the river, it will catch fish. But their husband cannot complain, because if he complains, you don't love me anymore, it's all those girls that you are seeing outside. Auntie, we know that we cannot stop men. If they want to cheat, whosoever that want to cheat will cheat. But let us help them to also make the right decision. Let us help them. Please, I think that even as a woman, I know that some women are very beautiful and their husband still cheat on them. I'm not saying these ideas that I've given you will help you stop your husband from cheating, but I'm just saying to you, these ideas I've given you will help to minimize. It will help to minimize, you know, the husband cheating on you. Sorry, the dog is barking. So anyway, I'm filming outside, as you can see. So this is the addiction of mistake that many married women make. Please don't say that, I beg, he has known me for donkey years, I cannot be bothered. Be bothered, though. Be bothered. Wear that makeup, wear that perfume. When you are going to bed, have a shower, smell nice, change your bed sheet, make everything look good around you. If you cannot, as you can see, if you cannot afford plaiting your hair, auntie, cut it, rub cream on it in the morning and comb it and let it be shiny. Remember, always put in the back of your mind that he that finds the wife has found the good thing. Make sure you are a good thing in the life of your husband. Don't be a disaster. God bless you. Have a good day. Bye.